दृष्टि कृतारी वंचने दृष्टि येनांजन मलीमसा अच्युताय नमस्तस्मै परमौचित्य कारिणे. In the rasa chapter, we have dealt with seven rasas. Now we have the last two rasas, Adbhuta and Shanta. In Adbhuta rasam, he takes an example of Chandaka. This is in the form of a conversation. And so Krishnena amba gatena rantu madhuna mridbakshita swechaya satyam Krishna ka eva maha musali nityamba pashyananam vyadehiti vikasite atha vadane drishtva samastam jagan mata yasya jagama vismaya padam payatsa keshavaha. So the whole thing is in a conversation between Balrama. Balrama comes and informs Yashodama that Krishna has eaten mud, mridbhakshita iti, and then she questions Krishna. When he opens his mouth, what she sees inside is extremely, very fascinating for her. So there, by describing that entire scene, he says it is Adbhutarasam here. So it is in the shloka is in the form of a conversation here. So Krishnena amba rantum katena Krishnena adhuna swechaya mritbakshita. He automatically took that mud and ate it. Yashoda said, Satyam Krishna, is it true? She's asking Krishna, Kayeva Maha, who said that? Nobody, I did not eat any mud or anything. So Musalaha is the weapon that Balrama carries. So Musali, Mithyamba, Pashyananam. No, it is all false, whatever Balrama said. Look at my mouth, Pashyananam. So Yashoda says, Vyadehi iti vikasite vadhane atha. And then when she said, open your mouth and show, he opened his mouth and showed Yashoda, vadhane vikasite sati drishtva samastam jagat. She saw the entire universe inside. The way it is described is very beautiful in the sense, Anga, inside that universe, she sees a Gokulam, and inside that, there is Ananda Bhavanam. There, another Yashoda and Krishna are, and Yashoda is looking at Krishna's mouth, where there is another. So that it's like that, a series of mirrors. If you keep two mirrors against each other and how you see it, that's how it was. So, samastam jagat mata yasya vadane drishtva. Yasya vadane drishtva, samastam jagat drishtva mata vismaya padam jagama. Yashoda attained that, she realized, she was very surprised by looking at the entire world in his mouth. Saha keshavaha vaha payat. Another beautiful, you should read Krishna Karnamritam when you get time. There are so many beautiful small incidents that he will explain, which will give you that Adbhuta rasam. In one, he says, Antargrihe drishtva Krishnam choram, Antargrihe Krishnam avekshya choram, badhva kavatam jananim gatasa. One gopi, what she did was she saw Krishna, stealing butter. So what she did was she closed the door so that he cannot escape, and then went to inform Yashoda. Antargrihe Krishnam avekshya choram badhva kavatam jananim gataika. There she saw, what did she see? Ulukale nibaddham. Ulukale damanibaddhamenam tatrapi drishtva stimita babhuva. The same, very similar, but the incident is very different, where she thinks that she has caught him and she has, imprisoned him in her house. She goes there and finds him ulukale nibaddham, ulukale dama nibaddham. He has been tied to that ulukalam, and there she says, Upanishadartham ulukale nibaddham. The essence of Upanishad has been tied in that ulukala. After seeing that, she is surprised. So there is the Adbhuta rasam. That Krishna Leela itself is an example of Adbhuta. Krishnena amba gatena rantum adhuna mridbakshita swechaya it doesn't need much of an explanation. You just have to experience that Adbhuta Rasam in this, right? Every Leela, Krishna Leela that is there is an example of that, of Adbhuta Rasam. So here, it is Pandura Anga only. I thought it was Panduranga, but there is a Dirgham there. So Atra, Pandura Anga Kara Sakshi Lakshita Mrit Bhakshana Akshepa Udyata Janani Bhaya Chakitasya Apannavakarinaha Shishoho Vikasita Asyasya. All of this, the first two are an adjective for the Shishu Krishna. When the mother is, the moment the mouth is opened, she actually sees a lot of these indications where he has eaten mud, right? So Pandura Anga, his body is filled with is anointed with Panduram. Panduram means white. It's the mud in the on the river banks are more whitish than brownish. Right, it's that sand that is there. So his body is filled with white sand there. He's not Gauranga. He's Meghavarnaha, Shyamalavarnaha. So it's even more apparent that the sand is seen as white on his body. So Pandura Anga Kara, his hands and his body is filled with. I mean, it's got sand on it. And then that is the Sakshi. You know, and Sakshi Lakshitam also. Musali, Balrama has seen him also. So there is a witness for his action. There is evidence on his body and his hand that he has eaten mrit. So mrit bhakshana, akshepa udyata. When someone has accused him of mrit bhakshanam, so udyata janani bhaya chakitasya. Janani, Mata is actually, she's afraid. Have you eaten mud? You know, what is it going to do to you? I don't know. So she is afraid of that. But Shishu Krishna wants to first remove that fear from her. So Apannavakarinaha, he tries to cheat her by opening his mouth and showing the entire world. You know, you don't need to feel afraid of anything that this eating that mud is going to do something to me. So Janani Bhayachakitasya, or another way to see is because you know she is angry, he feels that Krishna is trying to show that he is afraid of that also. That won't fit here so much, but it's more to remove that fear that is there in the mother. So Apannavakarinaha Shishoho Vikasita. So he opens his mouth, Antaha Samasta Jagat Darshanena Matuhu Tat Prabhava Anavignataya Vatsalya Vihvalayaha Vismaya Gamanena. If it was someone who understood his greatness, then there is no Adbhutam there. Okay, you know that Krishna is an avatar of Vishnu. For us, maybe we don't understand the greatness, but still, if you are able to appreciate him as a young kid, then it will be an Adbhuta Rasam for us. If you always think of him in that swarupam and not think of him as, you know, an avataram of Vishnu, everything is possible for him. That is not how we look at Krishna. The moment you think of Krishna, the image that comes to your mind is a nice, round, chubby, cute boy. So everything that he does is a vismayaspadam. And so tat prabhava anabhijnataya, more so with Yashoda, who is completely unaware of his greatness. Tat prabhava anabhijnataya, vatsalya vikvalayaha, she is that exceeding love for his her child, that vatsalyam vikvala. So she doesn't know what to do. The moment she looks at it, vismayagamanena, she is surprised. Ati uchitaha ayam adbhuta atishayaha. So the Adbhuta Rasam here is very appropriate the way it is described here. Next one is Anuchitam. So where Adbhuta Rasam is Anauchityam, he takes from his own, Kshemendra gives an example from his Muni Mata Mimamsa, Yatha, Samasta Ascharyanam Jalanidhi Aparaha Savasatihi. ततोप्याश्चर्यं यत् पिबति सलिलं तं किल मुनिः इदं तु अत्याश्चर्यं लघु कलश जन्मा अपि यदसौ परिच्छेत्तुं कोवा प्रभवति तव आश्चर्य सरणि. फर्स्ट ही लुक्स एट दि आश्चर्य सरणि और द लिस्ट ऑफ सरप्राइजिंग एंड यूनिक थिंग्स दैट दैट हैव बीन क्रिएटेड इन दिस वर्ल्ड. सो समस्त आश्चर्याणां जलनिधिः अपारः जलनिधिः एव समस्त आश्चर्याणां वसतिः अस्ति. सो फर्स्ट आइटम दैट सरप्राइजेस एवरीबडी इज द वास्ट ओशन बिकॉज इट इज अ रिपोजिटरी ऑफ मेनी यूनिक एंड डिफरेंट थिंग्स इन द वर्ल्ड एंड वी स्टिल डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द डेप्थ ऑफ द ओशन. We may have crossed so many, you know, on Earth, it is easier to understand and we have probably taken an inventory of all the things that are there on Earth. But even now and in this day and age, there are people who talk about mysteries of the ocean. So it means there are so many different surprising things that can, you know, people are discovering even today newer, animals or objects or corals or plants or whatever it is. So it is like a huge repository, a kosham of aascharya vastu. So samasta aascharyanam vasatihi saha aparaha jalanidihi. That endless ocean, that vast ocean is supposed to be the irpidam. It is the living place or it is the residence of a lot of so unique things. Now then, even more ascharyam than that is tataha api ascharyam yat tam salilam. As I told you, it is an endless ocean. But Agastya drank the entire ocean. Right? Tam salilam munihi kila pipati. He drank the entire oceans, the waters of the entire ocean. That is even more surprising. Idam tu atyascharyam. This is the most surprising of all, that this muni who drank the ocean is kalasha janma, laghu kalasha janma. He just came from a small kalasham. Api yat asau. So tava ascharya saranim parichetum kaha prabhavati. So who can discern your entire this list of surprising things that you have created in this world? Who can discern that and understand the greatness of that? So kraha prabhavati kasya shaktihi asti parichetum parishilayitum tava ascharya saranam. So tava here means it is the creator, or you can say ishaha, because it is his greatness that because of which this entire creation is there. Correct. Now, where is the, he is talking about all the Ascharya Padam, but he ends it with that Arthantara Nyasa, which sort of spoils that Adbhuta Rasam here. In the sense, he says, there is nothing to be surprised about, because your creation itself is like this. So who can understand your creation? Which means you are so great that it is natural that you can create certain things. Correct? So when there is a natural thing to it, like for example, just as I said in the earlier shlokam, where if we know that Krishna is the, you know, avataram of Vishnu and he can do all these things, then there is no ascharyam there. You will think it is a natural thing for Krishna to do it. But you still look at him only as that baby. Right? A small boy of a 5-year-old boy who is doing so many things. You have to think of him like that and then you can understand that Adbhuta Rasam. If someone says, yeah, he is an avatar of Vishnu, he can do everything, then there is no Adbhuta Rasam for that person. He is not a Sahridaya there at that point. So here anyway, there is no, this shlokam is like that for you. So what is the vritti that he says? Atra apara saritpati prabhavena munina tasya eka chuluka achamanena. Eka chulukam is one hand, like achamanam, he just drank the entire samudram. So apara saritpati prabhavena, this entire saritpati saritam pati hi samudraha, his prabhavam, and that
hmm.
ప్రభావేణ మునినా ఏక చుడుక ఆచమనేన. ఐ థింక్ యూ షుడ్ పుట్ ఇట్ లైక్ దిస్. అపార సరిత్పతి ప్రభావః యస్య సః తాదృశః మునిః ఏక చులుకేన ఆచమనేన. ఐ డోంట్ నో హౌ దట్ కమ్స్. సరే వరలే అన్వయం వరల. లెట్ మీ సీ హౌ దిస్ గోస్. సో ద ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఫస్ట్ లైన్ హీ టాక్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రభావ ఆఫ్ సరిత్పతి. కరెక్ట్ వన్ మినిట్ be there. Okay. So the first sentence he talks about apara saritpati prabhavena, that is the greatness of the samudram. Next is tasya samudrasya ekachulaka achamanena munina, and then that samudra he just did an achamanam with one chulukam, means one handful, tadrasha munina. That is the second one, second line. And then the third one is munehe laghu kalasha janmana, because and by highlighting that birth of kalasha janma, birth of agastya. Now what is this? You first show the greatness of the samudram, and then one chulukam is smaller than the kalasham. Kalasham is bigger, so there is no proper process to revealing that adbhuta rasam. In if you remember in veera rasam, he was talking of how Kartavirya Arjuna's Ravana's prowess was put down by Kartavirya Arjuna, and then Kartavirya Arjuna's hands were put down by Parashurama, and Parashurama was won over by Rama. So there is a progression to that veeratva, whereas here there is no proper progression. Or even if you want to show that, there should be a even the regression should be proper. Like here he says apara sarit, which is big, then chulukam is small, kalasha janma is in the medium, so there is an asamam, it is vishama, right? The vismaya aspadam, or that the surprising thing that he is showing here, the adbhuta process, the flow is not progressive. Okay, it is not equal. So there is an up and down in it like a wave. So first it is vast, and then chulukam, and then you have the kalasha, right? So iti ayam, okay, krama akranti samarudaha api, even though he is showing a process here, asama vismaya mayaha ayam adbhuta prasaraha. This adbhuta prasara, this flow of adbhuta rasam, is actually asama or vishama. It is not equal, or it is not correct. Samsarasya evam vidha eva aascharya saranihi. This process, this list of aascharyam, aparichinna, so it cannot be analyzed, it cannot be understood. So what happens? Na kinchit etat kautukam. So there is no curiosity by which, you know, in the sense, what he is doing is this arthantarnyasa samarthena sahasaiva aropitaha tirobhutatamcha upagataha. So immediately you are actually showing the aascharyam, and then you are quickly making it disappear by saying that there is nothing to be curious about this aascharya sarani that has been created by you. Correct? Nobody can understand it. So why even try to think about it? So we don't get the curiosity to understand that aascharyam of the world. You understand? So that adbhuta rasam is brought about, and then it is quickly removed. Tirobhutatam upagataha. Why? Because of the arthantarnyasa. If we had continued with something else, or put it in front and above, or shown different things, then it is better. I think there is one shlokam in Niti Shatakam, where he says, you know, Sheshaha, the Bhumi is being born by Shesha, and Shesha is you is being
Baru Sakradyukta Turanga Eva Adva.
Ide?
Baru Sakradyukta Turanga Eva Shesho Vahita Bhumi Bharahan on Orme.
Ama.
And the Idilla Shakuntalatla.
Shakuntalam illa, Adilla. Now, soldier the Nithi Shatakatla, Nana in the Adadu. భూమి ఆ భూమియ భారత వంద శేషం తూకరా ఇల్ కూర్మ అవతారం తూకరదు కూర్మత్త తాంగిండ్రుకరదు సరిత్పతి అబడినుట్టు వరు ఒరు there will be a gradation of things that comes in that. I forgot. That's okay. So as long as you maintain that gradation of Ascharyam, then it would have served as a good Adbhutarasa shloka. Whereas here he spoils that effect by bringing in that Arthantranyasam and saying there is nothing, you know, it is a lokokti. See, by Arthantranyasam itself is you are doing a samarthanam or justifying it. Once you are justifying it, then which means you are saying there is nothing in this to give rise to an Adbhuta. Correct? So that is why he takes the shloka as an example for Adbhutarasa Anauchitya.
Okay.
Next he moves to,
What is Nyasa?
Nyasamma.
Like Arthantara Nyasa, Nyasam Miti.
Okay, no. Arthantara Nyasa means you are, it is an Alankara. Sorry, I should have explained that. Okay. So Arthantara Nyasam is a type of Alankara where you are showing, for the example for that is Hanuman Abdim Matarathu Kim Dushkaram Mahatmanam. So that is the example that is there in Chandraloka and Kuvalyanandam. Hanuman Abdim Matarathu. Hanuman crossed the ocean. Kim Dushkaram Mahatmanam. What is difficult for great people? Now you are justifying this, the action of Hanuman, by saying that Hanuman is a great person and there is nothing that is difficult for a great person. Hence, the action of Hanuman crossing the ocean is justified. So in the same way here, there are so many Ascharya things that are there in the world, and your creation is filled with such unique and surprising things that nobody can, you know, understand the greatness of you. We're talking about God here, Ishaha. Correct? So that justifies that even if you come up with 100 more Ascharya items, it will still be in one among the 1,000 Ascharya things that you have created in this world. So it gets justified. It does not give rise to an Adbhuta Rasam and for you to enjoy the greatness that is there in front of you. It's more of a Shantarasam probably, you know, it might lead to Shantarasa, where or the Deva Vishayaka Rati. You like the God so much and you're thinking about how great he is. That's all it is. It's not about the Ascharyam or the Adbhutarasam. So here Arthantara Nyasaha means you are highlighting another meaning to justify what is the Prakritam, what is the contextual. That is your Arthantara Nyasa Alankara.
Oh, thank you, Akka.
No problem. So next is Shantarasam. Mama, Shante Yatha Mama Chaturvarga Sangrahe. So in his text, Chaturvarga Sangraham, he has written the shloka. This one is also a debated shloka where many people have highlighted this as Bhartrihari's shloka. Bhoge Roga Bhayam, Sukhe Kshaya Bhayam, Vitte Agni Bhubhrit Bhayam, Dasye Swami Bhayam, Gune Khala Bhayam, Vamshe Kuyoshit Bhayam, Mane Mlani Bhayam, Jaye Ripu Bhayam, Kaye Kritantad Bhayam, Sarvam Nama Bhave Bhaved Bhayam, Aho Vairagyam Eva Bhayam. In this world, everything is associated with some sort of a fear in this world. Whereas Vairagya or Viragasya Bhavaha, Vigataha, Ragaha, Viragaha, Viragasya Bhavam, Vairagya. If you are free of attachment, then you don't need to worry about anything. There need not be any fear in your life. So Bhave, in this world, Sarvam Nama Bhavet Bhayam. Sarvam Bhayam Bhavet. Everything in this world you have something to fear of. If you possess, every possession in this world has something that you have to fear from. In this, so he lists all that by saying bhoge, bhoge, vishaya sukhe. If you are trying to enjoy things in this world, every sense organ tries to enjoy something or the other in this world, then roga bhayam. You're afraid of fear. In the matters of enjoyment, you're afraid of disease. Right? If you see too much of screen and you try to enjoy, give enjoyment for your eyes, then there is roga bhaya. You are afraid that your eyes will get hurt. Same way, you eat more, you give in to that taste, then you are afraid of rogam in your body. Boge roga bhayam. Sukhe kshaya bhayam. If you're very happy, you're always worried about, suppose I don't have this money, what will happen? You're very happy today because you have attained this. Suppose I don't have this. Everybody is always thinking about, in a pessimistic manner, saying, what will happen? You're thinking about your future constantly, right? Why are you saving money today? For retirement. If at the time of retirement, I don't have money, what do I do? Sukhe kshaya bhayam. Vitte, now I have money. What will happen? Suppose a fire comes in my house and I lose all my possessions, what will happen? I lose my passport, my bank statements, everything, then gone. Agni bhayam, bhubrit bhayam. Government is taking taxes. I earn 40% is going to the government. So bhubrita is raja here. So vitte, in the matters of wealth, you are afraid of either some calamity. Agni is a representative of some calamity. You have hurricane, whatever can happen, right? Nature's plague can come, or the king is going to take it away from you in the name of taxes. Dasye, if you're a slave or if you're working, dasyam means not only slavery, you're a slave to the company in which you're working. Swami bhayam, you have to be afraid of the boss who is there. Do everything that the boss says. So swami bhayam. Gune khala bhayam, you say a person, we are always afraid, you know, I have brought up my child very well, but I am not sure about what his peers are thinking. So khala bhayam, if he is associated with bad people, then his character might change. So gune, when you have a good character, khala bhayam, you are afraid of good bad people. Even if you have good character, you are afraid that if you are associated with a bad person, you will be forced to do with that peer pressure. Vamshe, ku yoshit bhayam. Why? Kuputra bhayam is also there. Not only yoshit means stri. If in a great ancestry, every person who is in a kulam, in a good kulam, they are afraid of a bad woman in that. It's just a bad sheep in any family. I won't accept this. So any person who is with a bad character can destroy that kulam. Mane mlani bhayam. Mane is let's say nobility. You know, if you have nobility or noble character, you are afraid of mlani is a fading of. I couldn't just place that mlani. Bring garche. You are afraid of losing that nobility. Noble character, that is mlani is fading away. Okay, jaye, in matters of victory, you are afraid of an enemy. Ripu bhayam. Kaye, once you are in this body, you are afraid of death. Kritanta bhayam. Sarvam nama bhave bhave bhayam. Aho vairagyameva abhayam. Abhayam is two meanings here. One is vairagyam eva bhayam, bhaya rahitam asti, abhayam means sharanam. So it is better to go and surrender with vairagya or detachment than be in this world and constantly being attacked by fear from all sides. Easier said than done. Atra sakala jana abhimata bhoga sukha vittadinam bhayamayataya. What are all the process that he takes to highlight the shantarasam? Shantarasasya nirargana marga vitaranam uchitataram upadishtam. It has been advised here in the shloka, upadishtam uchitataram. A very appropriate shantarasa has been said here. Nirargana marga vitaranam. Argalam means a stop or pratibandakam. Nirargalam means without any stop. Okay, so a beautiful path has been shown, an unopposed path for the Shantarasa has been said in an appropriate manner. Using all these things, by saying what are all the things that he has said, Sakala jana abhimata bhoga sukha vittadinam bhayamayataya. by showing that all these bhoga, sukha and vittha, these are all the things that are abhimatam, which have been accepted by sakala jana, everybody has been contributing towards, you know, something that people greedily go after. Correct? They want all these things. Bhoga, sukha and vitta are the things that people pursue in this world. So sakala jana abhimata bhoga sukha vittadinam bhayamayataya, having been, they are filled with the bhayam, showing that. The next is heyatam pratipadya, and showing that these have to be avoided. So sarvam bhayam vairagyameva abhayam, sarvam bhayayuktam asti iti heyatam pratipadya. So he shows that these have to be avoided because no one in this world wants to be with fear constantly. Correct? So it is better to avoid something that is associated with fear. Heyatam pratipadya. Vairagyameva sakala bhaya ayasa shamana. Ayasam is making an effort in this world which is filled with the things to be feared, or filled with things which are associated with fear. And vairagyam is something that shows a path to stop all these things. Shamanam, a destruction of all these things. And more than a destruction, it is a cessation of that. You stop your involvement in all these things, and it shows a manodhairyam that is associated with it. Okay? You have to cultivate vairagyam. Vairagyasya upadeyataya. That vairagyam has to be cultivated. So you're showing that the world is filled with fear, hence it has to be avoided, and vairagya has to be cultivated. By pointing out all these three, he has brought out Shantarasam in a very beautiful manner in the shloka. Okay, another example also he says here. Bhoge rogabhayam sukhe kshayabhayam ditte agni bhupratbhayam. A different way of showing is Kusuma Shayanam, how a Jeevan Mukta should behave, or he behaves, how he looks upon everything in this world. See, first is Heyata. In the earlier shloka, he said how to avoid the objects in this world and be without detachment. Another way is, more than avoiding, you just look at everything as equal. Samam. Like how in Mukha Panchashati, he said, Shiva Shiva Pashyanti Samam Kamakshi Katakshita Purushaha Vipinam Bhavanam Amitram Vitram Loshtam Cha Yuvati Bimboshtam. You look at everything in an equal manner. That is another way of approaching the world. You don't need to avoid and stay in a secluded place. Right? You can be in this world, at the same time not be attracted by it. Right? Sukadukke Samaya Kritva Labhalabhav Jaya Jaya. Now, this shlokam points out that. So, yathava mama muni mata mimamsayam kusuma shayanam pashanova priyam bhavanam vanam pratanu masrana sparsham vasaha tvagapi atha taravi sarasam ashanam kulmashahava dhanani trinaniva shama sukha sudha apana kshabye samam hi mahatmanam. I think it is Kshaibye. Kshaibyeva. Kshaibye dama. In a Kshivadatu da, it is Kshivati or Kshivyati means you're getting intoxicated by it. Sudha pana Kshaibye samam mahatmana. So they are, they get intoxicated by Shama Sukha. Shama is Indriya Nigraham. So Indriya Nigraham, the Sukha that you get from Indriya Nigraham, that is like an Amritam, Sudha. The Sudha Yaha Panena Kshaibye Sati Unmattata Dasha Vartate Mahatmanam. So Mahatmanam Samam Sarvam, when they are in that intoxicated state of experiencing that Sukham that comes from Shama, everything is equal for them. What are equal? Kusuma Shayanam, Pashanaha, whether it is a flower bed or stone, Pashanaha, or if it is a favorite residence, Priyam Bhavanam, Athava Vanam, or if it is a forest. Pratanu Masranam, Pratanu is thin Masranam, soft to touch, Masrana Sparsham Vasaha, like satin, no? Thin, beautiful, soft clothes, or Taravi Twak, Taru Sammandhi Taravi Twak, Balkalam. Or whether it is a bark garment. Sarasam Ashanam. Nice tasty food or Kulmashaha. Kulmashaha means, in the Asuri Sampatthala, Yatayamam, Gatarasam, Putim, Paryushitam Chayatu, Uchishtam, Chamedhyam Cha, Bojanam, Tamasi Priyam, Tamasa Priyam. So the everything that is tamasa priyam, tamasa guna adhikye, these are all the things that we like. Yata yamam, that which is crossed one yama, the food that you prepare, and if it is beyond one jama, which is 3 hours or 1.5 hours, depends. So if it is crossed that, then it is no longer fit to be eaten by sattvaguna pradhana. It is a tamasa food. Puti. Gata rasam, that which does not have any taste. Puti means which is fermented. Anything fermented is also tamasa food. So here kulmasha is that fermented grains, some food that has been made with fermented grains. Whether it is that or it is sarasam ashanam, or if it is tasty food. Dhanani trinani va, whether it is wealth or grass. It doesn't matter. Mahatmanam etat sarvam samam. They look at it with an equal drishti, samadrishti. Atra sakala vikalpa talpa rahita. So this one huge samasam is for those people who look at this world in a very equal manner, because their mind is constantly in that anandam. Brahma swarupa anandam. You know, Brahma, dukkha janma pravritti dosha mithya jnananam uttarottara apaye apavargaha. So those who have removed that mithya ajnanam from their mind and are in that Brahma swarupa or experiencing that Brahma anandam, that is that moksha swarupa and that moksha stage. Those people who are in that stage, what is, how do they look at all these things? Sakala vikalpam, this dichotomy that is there in this world, you know, the contrasting features that are there. Sukha, dukkha, labha, alabha, jaya, parajaya. That vikalpam, it is not there in their mind. Okay, all these contrasting features are absent in their mind. So sakala vikalpa talpa rahitam. Talpa means it is the substratum of all these contrasting features is that mithya ajnanam. Hence, they have an abheda bhava. They have an attitude of non-difference towards the things in the world. Abheda bhava, bhasaha, that bhavam is there in their mind. Vasa samana atma tattva. Everything else in this world is abhedam, or they see the non-difference. And because of why? Because their mind is completely surrendered in that Atma Tattva. So Atma Tattva Vishranti Janita, because of that Sarvasamya Samullasitam. Okay, that Atma Tattvam is described as where all these contrasting features have come and they've merged into that Atma Tattva. So dukkha janma pravritti, dukkham is your the janma that you take is because of the karma that you have done. So that prompts a janma, and then because of that janma you have a pravritti, you have an intention to perform further actions. That pravritti dosham, that is the dosha, and that dosham is represented by the mithya jnanam, that this world is permanent. See, jagat satyam iti yat mithya jnanam, that is moved, that is removed, right? And then they attain. So how is it removed? It is removed by apavarga. And what is apavarga? Apavarga is Brahmatmaikatva Jnanam is Apavarga, which is Moksha. So that Atma Tattvam is where all these contrasting features merge and become one, where you see only that Atma Tattvam and this Mithya Jnanam is removed. Okay, so Sakala Vikalpa Talparahita Abheda Bhava Bhasa Samana Atma Tattve Vishrantihi Yesham. Tat Atma Tattva Vishranti Janyam Yat Sarva Samanyam. So they look at everything as equal because of their, they are in that Brahmanandam. So Samullasita. Next, Shama Sukha. Now that is the happiness. That is that Anandam because they have controlled their sense organs. Controlled is more like, you know, your sense organs are always going everywhere and you have controlled it. I think it is more a cessation of the activities on their own. It's not that they have tried to control it. So Shama Sukha Piyushapana. Piyusham is Amritam. Amritapanat Uditam Uditaha Anandaha Nitya Anandaha Anandena Gurnamana Manasaha. So the people whose mind is completely intoxicated with that Anandam. Now what do they do? Priya Apriya Sukha Dukkhadishu Mahatam Sadrishi Pratipattihi. They have a common attitude towards Priya Apriya Sukha and Dukkha. The Pratipatti or Jnanam. They have a equal Jnanam among these objects. Iti Jivan Mukti Samuchitam Abhihitam. It is the status of the Jivan Mukti is being described in this. More than the shlokam, his vritti needs one small lesson on Advaita, on Advaita Vedanta. Kusuma Shayanam Pashanova Priyam Bhavanam Vanam Pratanu Masrina Sparsham Vasaha Tvagapi Athataravi Sarasam Ashanam Kulmashova Dhanani Trinaniva Shama Sukha Sudha Apana Kshaivye Samamhi Mahatmana. Next, he points out in Anauchityam. The shloka is actually taken as an example in Kavya Prakasha for Shantarasa. The same way as I said in Bhayanaka Rasa, where he takes an example of Griva Banga Viramam as Bhayanakam, which is actually a Swabhavukti Alankara and not Rasam. The same way here, he says it is not Uchitam for Shantarasam. It is there, yes, but it is not very appropriate. The Shanta Rasam is gone. The first three lines are okay, but the last line is gone. Ahauva Hareva Balavati Ripauva, and he quotes this as Utpala Rajas. Utpala Raja is Abhinavagupta's guru. Ahauva Hareva Balavati Ripauva Sukhridiva Manauva Loshteva Kusuma Shayaneva Drishadiva Trineva Straineva Mama Samadrishaha Yanti Divasaha Kochit Punyaranye Shiva Shiva Shiveti Pralapataha. Beautiful shlokam, but we have to look at the Anausityam later. So Ahauva Hareva Ahihi Sarpaha. So Sarpeva Hareva, whether it is a serpent or Haram, a beautiful garland. Balavati Ripo, if it is a very strong enemy, or Sukhriti, or a friend. Samadrishaha. So these are all for a person who is looking at all these things with an equanimity. So Manova Loshteva, whether it is a great gem or Loshtam is Mritpindam or Loshta is iron. Kusuma Shayaneva Drishadiva, whether it is a flower bed or stone. Trineva, Straineva, whether it is grass or Strainam, the entire host of women, the group of Strainam is three Samuhaha. Samadrishaha Mama, looking at everything equally, Mama Divasaha Yanti. My days are spent by looking, where are they spent? Kvachit Punyaranye, in some Punyakshetram. Shiva, 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 iti pralapataha, by saying, you know, Shiva, 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 pralapataha, by talking of Shiva, my days are spent. What is the problem that Kshemendra finds here? Atra, jivan mukta uchitam. It is appropriate in describing the jivan mukta lakshanam, where he says priya, apriya, ragadvesha, upashama. Both all these contrasting features are upashama, they are gone, are controlled. Lakshana moksha kshamam, so that is moksha. Removing of all these contrasting features is your, or looking at everything with equanimity is moksha. Sarva samyam, ahi hara sukrut ari, samadrishti rupam, looking at everything is with equanimity. Abhidatata, as he is saying this, he also says, kvachit punyaranye, why should there be a punyaranyam for him to stay? See, then which means he is not looking at everything with samadrishti. There is a vikalpa there. He is differentiating between what is an, something which is normal and something which is punyakshetra. Right? Punyaranyam means a very pavitra hermitage. Correct? So, he is showing a contrast there by mentioning kvachit punyaranye. In some punyakshetram, I want to spend my time. So, kvachit punyaranye yat abhihitam, that is vikalpa pratipadakam, where he is showing a difference of level between certain places in the world and certain places. Okay, so abheda vasana viruddham, it is different, or it is opposing to the idea of non-difference that he is showing in the shloka. Correct? So abheda vasanayaha viruddha vishayaha atra viruddha vishayaha pratipaditaha anuchitam avabhasati. Correct? So dhara adhirudha sarvasamya vigalita bheda abhimana granthehe. He he justifies why he is saying that it's anuchitam by saying that dhara adhirudha sarvasamyam. That sarvasamyam, looking at everything with equanimity, is something that goes on in the mind as a dhara, as a flow. Dhara adhiruda sarvasamya vigalita bheda abhimana granthehe. That the he sarvam shivamayam pashyataha. Tapovane nagara avaskara kutecha. He should be able to look at it with a samana drishti. Whether it is nagara avaskara kute, whether it is a city which is bustling with activity, or in a tapovanam, he should look at it, look at everything with equanimity. Correct? He can't, because he looks at everything as shivamayam. Kvachit punye aranyeva, or nagare aranyeva, if he had said nagare aranyeva, or kvachit jagati, shiva 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 iti pralapataha, wherever it may be in this world, if he could have, you know, not mentioned just punyaranyam and said kvachit vipule jagati shiva 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 iti pralapataha, then it is fine. Correct? So sarvatra sarvam shivamayam pashyataha. Adarthla abheda granthiyo. See, that is actually abheda granthihi. Abheda adhara adiruda sarvasamya vigalita abheda abhimana granthehe. We have an idea of abhedam, non-difference, and look at everything. Sarvam shivamayam iti pashyataha kasyachit purushasya or tapasasya tapovaneva nagareva vimala atmalabha triptataya. He can attain atma swarupam or atmanandam wherever it is. Vimala, a very pure atmalabha, that atma tattvam can be, he is just satisfied with thinking about the Brahma Swarupa. He need not, it doesn't matter whether it is the Tapovanam or the Nagaram. So, kvachit punya aranyadi vachanam to anuchitameva. Okay? It's true. You can say kvachit vipule aranye or vipule jagati would have been something, you know, something to it, to that effect, which also fits the meter, then would have been better. Ahova hareva balavati ripova sugridiva manova loshteva. But it's a beautiful shlokam. It's also not probably a Jivan Mukta who is saying it. It can be a person who wants to attain that Jivan Mukti status, and he is, you know, looking for, if it is in a punyakshetram, then there is a more possibility of thinking only good thoughts than being in a place which is filled with bhogam. So even then, as far as shantarasa goes, it is anauchitya. Okay. stop with this. The next is Rasa Sankaryam, where two rasas are there, and there also he talks about Auchityam. He will go in detail about that also, Bhava, and then Karakam, Vyakaranam part will come. So till now we have seen some portions of the Alankara Shastra Auchitya sections. Any doubt?
Very beautiful, Akka. All shlokams today. I mean, Adbhutarasam was very good. The first one, especially Krishna's, you know, that is, we hear that from childhood, that is something that we hear all the time. But the way it is in that conversation, the way it has been expressed, it's so good.
That is, the shlokam there is also Bahadi Bhuvana Shreenim Sheshaha. See, Adbhutarasam, I told you in Niti Shatakam. See, Bahadi Bhuvana Shreenim, correct, Maandha. Sheshaha Phana Phalaka Stitam. कमठपतिना मध्ये पृष्ठं सदा सः विधीयते तमपि कुरुते क्रोडाधीनं पयोधिः अनादर अहः महतां निस्सीम चारित्र विभूतयः. इवन देर् इट् इस् अतान्तरन्यासं विच् स्टाप्स् दि अद्भुतरसम्. बट् द फस्ट् त्री लैन्स् आर् अद्भुतरसम्, वेर् ही सेस् द शेष केरीस् दिस् 14, द भुवनश्रेणीं वहति. All the 14 worlds, Shesha Anantan is carrying that. And then the Ananta is being carried upon the, by Kurma, Kamatapatina Madhye Prishtam. And that Kamatapati also, he is being supported by, Kurma Avatara is being supported by this Payodhi, the Kshirabdi. Mahatam Charitra Bhutayaha is Nisimanaha. It's, there is no... Seema for their ascharyam.
Very beautiful. Thank you so much, Akka.
Okay, no problem.
How are you doing today?
இல்ல புரியல எனக்கு.
சமன் ஒரு வார்த்தை இருந்தது இல்லையா ஸ்லோகத்துல, இதுக்கு முன்னாடி ஸ்லோகத்துல.
See, shamaha is the sthayi bhavam for shantarasam. Even in adbhutarasam, if you see, vismaya padam agat jagama. Vismaya is mentioned there. Kshemendra, then we should say that Kshemendra is okay. Whereas Abhinava Gupta is very, very strict that rasa and bhava should not be mentioned by the name. So Swapada Vachyam should not be there is Abhinava Gupta's matam. Then Kshemendra should probably accept it. That is what we can see from this. Yeah. It's an opinion difference, tha, you know. If his main gripe, Abhinav Gupta's main gripe with the, who's that, Bhavabhuti, is that he mentions Eko Rasa Karuna Yeva. He mentions Rasam, the name of that Rasa. He mentions the Bhava. He mentions Kampa, everything. Then it is not good. That, he's very a strong believer in that. Abhinav Gupta is a strong believer in the fact that you should not mention the Rasa by its name. You should not mention the bhavam by its name. He is okay with this. So it's okay if shama is mentioned. Not a problem. Even if it is a sthayi bhava. Okay.